I want to talk a little bit about what creates the conditions for the best outcomes from neurofeedback and the biggest mistake that people make. So the biggest mistake people make is the training that we all have, which is I'm going to pop a pill and then that pill's going to do the trick and it's going to make my life better. And instead of it being a physical pill, in this case, it's the neurofeedback. I'm just going to do the neurofeedback and then things are going to get better. And what I want you to understand is that, yes, the neurofeedback piece is definitely going to help your limbic brain calm down. It's going to make your brain function better. But you still have to decide what your priorities are and what you want to accomplish. So let me use the analogy of a car and a driver and the example of improved relationships. So the neurofeedback piece is the car. It keeps the car on the road so that you don't veer off, you don't crash into a tree. That's your limbic brain making it function better so you're not in that reactive mode. You're better emotionally regulated. You're calmer, you're less impulsive. You're focusing when you need to focus, right? So that's the car staying on the road. But you still have to decide where you want to take that car. So if we talk about relationships and communication in relationships, when your limbic brain is calmer and you're more emotionally regulated and you can focus, it creates the conditions for you to have better communication and better relationships. But you still have to decide with your prefrontal cortex that that's a priority of yours. So then you have to say, okay, I'm going to spend more time with this person. I'm going to be thoughtful about what I say. I'm going to think before I speak. I want to cultivate respect with my children and weigh what they say and not just communicate reactively. And so when you recognize what your priorities are, and your limbic brain is now in the zone to be able to be calmer and let your prefrontal cortex be in charge, then you can actually accomplish those goals. But you still have to decide that that's what you want. And so when you combine your limbic brain functioning better, calming down, plus your prefrontal cortex, that's your willful self saying, this is where I want to get to. This is the destination, and I'll do these things to get there. Those two things combined lead to the best possible outcomes from your training.